Okay, a couple of more things we're going to talk about for efficient buzz. Again, this is for a clean tone that makes everything easier for high notes. Okay, when we're talking about basics of mouthpiece placement, some of the biggest stuff is the up and down and the side to side. People have argued about the, you know, two-thirds, one-thirds, 50-50 and stuff like that. And I have found that most of the time, the different lip shape and stuff like that makes it so it's not that big of a deal. You can adapt. What I do find the biggest thing is, in terms of the up and down, is you gotta make sure that this, that the rim, the top rim, is not sitting too much onto the vermilion. So this bump across here is called the vermilion border, and this part right down here is your vermilion. If you play a note and you pull it off your face, there's usually a little white ring, and you can look in the mirror for a second. And if that white ring is entirely on the vermilion, right down in here, that's on a thinner piece of skin, there's less muscle in there, it's much more likely to cause damage if you play with high pressure. And usually it's gonna be a fuzzier sound. Another piece of the puzzle is by it getting squished, it distorts the lip angle. And that's one of the biggest issues with creating fuzzy sound. So at that point, I recommend to do that air test thing that we talked about in the other video. And then when you place it, try to get it set up so that when you pull it off, you can see that little white ring, and it's at least on the vermilion border or maybe a teeny bit above it. Now again, everyone's lip's gonna be a little bit different and you might be able to find that, but it's very seldom that I've seen somebody, twice in my life, I've seen somebody very effective at playing with a great tone and great high range when the pressure was still on the top rim of the mouthpiece was on the vermilion. So it's possible, but it's extremely difficult. And for 99.9% of the people out there, I recommend moving the mouthpiece up at least high enough that it's sitting on the border, the vermilion border. Another piece of the puzzle that I don't think enough people talk about is this piece of right here, this lip right here. A lot of times people, the lip goes up, and I'm talking across here, right by the border of the wet and the dry. It comes up, and then so for some people, it dips down just right in the middle, and then it goes back on the other side. That little dip right there, down right here, sometimes people will have that. That extra skin in there does not have enough muscle to maintain the rigidity to be able to get the high notes. And so the solution I found for that one is to move a little bit to the right or a little bit to the left. What that does is it pins down that piece of skin right there so that it's kind of pinned down on one side. And then it also gives you a little bit more of the lip that has the muscle in it that you can control inside the mouthpiece. You can experiment with it and find, you know, how far you want to go. If you don't have that and you don't need it, then I recommend don't do that. Try to keep in the center. You want an equal distance between this strong point and this strong point reaching across the lip. So it's, if it's, you know, far over one side, this side's got a longer stretch, and so it's a little bit more work for that side. And so it's better to have it in the center. But something to look for if you're having a hard time getting a good clean sound is look and see when you go, do you see a little dip right down here on the lip? And if that's the case, then it's something to try. Start moving, try to move in the mouthpiece to the left or moving it to the right. Experiment, find where you get the best sound.